Hello viewers, welcome to Ekam Isaac Ed. Today we are going to discuss again another important topic from environment, that is a new tiger reserve is going to be notified soon by the government. So what is the tiger reserve we are referring and what is its location, what are all the key features, along with we'll also understand what is the concept of tiger reserve and who are mainly implementing this concept of tiger reserves, along with Project Tiger, tiger related conservation efforts, everything in a short and informative video. So first thing, let us understand the point of discussion is surrounding Ratapani Wildlife Sanctuary, and this is situated in the state of Madhya Pradesh. Let us understand by understanding its location on the map. So here you can see these are all the tiger reserves and wildlife sanctuaries, especially from the state of Madhya Pradesh. So notably, you have this Ratapani Tiger Reserve here. So this is a location, and you already know there's Panna National Park, Panna Tiger Reserve, Madhav National Park, Gandhi Sagar Wildlife Sanctuary, Kuno, you know, right? We all, and National Chambal Wildlife Sanctuary also we have. At the same time, we also have Sanjay Gandhi National Park, Bandhavgarh National Park, Kanha National Park, Satpura National Park, Pench National Park, right? Because you know that is the reason why Madhya Pradesh is also considered to be the tiger capital of India, right? So because of its high presence of high population of tigers in the Madhya Pradesh. So this is what Ratapani Wildlife Sanctuary is soon to be notified as tiger reserve. It is on the cards with the government. So it is serious on this regard. Let us understand its location in more important details. As I just briefed you, it is in the state of Madhya Pradesh and it is on the Narmada Hills. And most importantly, we need to understand it is located in the heart of Madhya Pradesh. The same time, one river, Kolar River, is passing through this particular national park, or you can say wildlife sanctuary. The same time, very famous ancient prehistoric site, Bhimbetka, rock cut paintings we have, no, rock cut cave paintings. So that is also present in this particular wildlife sanctuary itself. Bhimbetka is a very important prehistoric ancient site. So that is also situated within this Ratapani Wildlife Sanctuary. Then let us understand the landscape. What type of forests are generally seen here means we'll be coming across dry deciduous forests and some moist deciduous forests also in this particular wildlife sanctuary. Then what is the main type of flora that is dominating? Most of the forest, if you see, or in the wildlife sanctuary, more than 50% of the tree is dominated by teak itself, right? It is very famous and predominant there. At the same time, we also have many animals like chinkara, along with tiger, black buck. Okay, so like this, we have other animals also, civet type of cat also we have, and many other things are also found naturally in this particular habitat. Then let us understand what is a tiger reserve. Tiger reserve is a specific area demarcated for the conservation of tigers. And you know, there will be a core area surrounding, buffer area and transition area also will be part of this. So, right, so this is generally conserved, or this area was demarcated for conservation of tigers. What tiger are we referring to? Generally, Royal Bengal tiger, which is the national animal of India also. Then, how many tiger reserves are there in India? Answer in the comment section. And what is the latest entry also into the tiger reserve list? Answer also in the comment section. Then, who is actually notifying a tiger reserve means it is always the state government. Most of you may get confused here. It is not the central government or National Tiger Conservation Authority, but it is notified by the state government under Section 38, Clause 5 of Wildlife Protection Act of 1972. Then what is the first tiger reserve that was notified in 1973, soon after implementation of Project Tiger means it is Palamu Tiger Reserve in the state of Jharkhand. Palamu Tiger Reserve in the state of Jharkhand. So this is the very first tiger reserve also you need to understand. Then in terms of area, which is the largest tiger reserve means this Nagarjun Sagar Srisailam Tiger Reserve, which is the largest in terms of area, and smallest in terms of area is Bore Tiger Reserve in the state of Maharashtra. So these are the largest and smallest tiger reserves. Then let us understand about Project Tiger as well. So you know, Project Tiger was initiated in the year 1973, especially for tiger conservation, and then we started notifying tiger reserves also. Then what is a precondition? Any tiger reserve can also be a national park or wildlife sanctuary also. That means any national park in wildlife sanctuary, for example, Sariska National Park we have. So that was later turned to be a tiger reserve. Same is the case here with Ratapani Wildlife Sanctuary. Now it is a wildlife sanctuary, later it can be demarked as a tiger reserve. So what is the primary difference here? In national park, there will be strict restrictions on doing certain activities, like even agriculture, all these type of human related activities are strictly prohibited. It is completely demarked for protecting of one particular area. In wildlife sanctuary, generally one particular species cannot be only seen for protection, but a larger area to conserve an ecosystem, we generally demark it as a wildlife sanctuary, and there will be considerably less restrictions compared to the national park. That is how we have. And in India, if you know, 104 national parks we have in the present time. At the same time, we have almost 550 plus wildlife sanctuaries in the present context. Then we also need to understand there is also a body called National Tiger Conservation Authority, which generally implements this Project Tiger, as well as it will also take care about the tiger reserves. So if already there is a tiger reserve, and if that has to be denotified, then who will be the main body that is interested here? It is National Board for Wildlife. Again, another statutory body under Wildlife Protection Act of 1972, headed directly by the Prime Minister. So this body has to agree in case already notified tiger reserve has to be denotified. Then what type of body is this NTCA? It is also a statutory body established under Wildlife Protection Act of 1972, and it was established based on Tiger Task Force in the year 2005. So Tiger Task Force was constituted in the year 2005, and based on their recommendations in the year 2006, NTCA was constituted. Then who will be the chairman? It is the Ministry of Environment, Forests and Climate Change. Then what is the main job here? They need to implement Project Tiger. They need to ensure tiger related standards are maintained in tiger reserves and all other things. At the same time, they also need to maintain that center state relations in terms of conservation of tigers, because it is not only one particular domain. Then we also need to understand, with respect to Project Tiger, we have TX2 initiative, which is trying to aim, or which is aiming especially for doubling the tigers. And you already know India is having more than 70% of tiger population, and as per 2022 census, we have 3167 tigers. So I just told you what is tiger census. Every 4 years once we had this tiger census, and it started in 2006. Now next census view is going to be 5th tiger census, 2006, 2010, 2012, then we have 2014, 2018, and next it is going to be 5th tiger census. Okay, so that data was already out, in 3167 tigers we have in the present situation. Then who will be conducting this? National Tiger Conservation Authority along with Wildlife Institute of India is mainly the agency which is conducting this tiger census every 4 years once. And then what is the St. Petersburg Declaration on Tiger Conservation? This was signed in the year 2010, and in the place called St. Petersburg in Russia, where all the tiger range countries, especially 13 tiger range countries, have made a resolve to increase the population of tigers by 50%, at least doubling of the tigers by 2022. And India has reached this before itself in 2018 itself. That means 4 years ahead only, we have reached the doubling of tigers target. So this is one you have to understand. Then when we are generally talking about tiger related census, we also need to understand the mechanism, that is M-stripes. This was already asked by UPSC in the prelims. M-stripes is one camera trapping method which will count the straps that are there on the tiger. Based on that, they can assess the population of tigers. This is one you have to understand. Then here we have given the list of tiger reserves in the country. Most important notable ones are given here. You can see in the state of Telangana, we have only two, Kaval as well as Amrabad tiger reserve. So this is the largest we have, and the smallest you can see here, Bore in 2014. So let me also know the 54th and 55th tiger reserves, which are the latest entries into Indian tiger reserve list. Then let's see the practice question. Consider the following protected areas: Bandipur, Bhitarkanika, Manas and Sundarbans. How many of them are declared as tiger reserves already? Try to choose your answer and put in the comment section. Then, as we have reached end of the video, today we have discussed about what is India's new tiger reserve, soon to be declared by the government of India, in which state it was located, what are the geographical features in this particular context, along with what is the concept of tiger reserve, who will be maintaining the tiger reserves, and all other tiger-related conservation efforts are discussed in a short and informative video. If you found it informative and helpful as part of your preparation, let me know in the comment section. And if you want any further videos from our side in one particular topic, you can put in the comment section so that I can trace that and I can do as many videos as possible. This is from my side. Thank you. All the very best.